What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Heroes Hearth Warcraft 3. This is Kendrick, and I present to you another interview, this time with our reigning champion for the fight night, Little DC from Sweden, once again on the camera. So, Little DC, man, how have you been over the last 2 weeks? Anything new?
Hello, everyone. No, I've been pretty good. I had some injuries during playing handball, but besides that, I've been...
Not the hands, I hope, for the video games.
No, the backside of my leg. So pretty good for playing Warcraft.
Okay.
Pretty bad for everything else.
Yeah, I can see. Did you get? Can you stay off work, or does that?
Yeah,
not really
I can
do
work
anything?
From home, so that's a great.
That's good. Good and bad at the same time, depending on how you want to see it.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, so 2 weeks ago we had you on the show against Shaddai, and you dethroned him. You took the title away from him. Tell us a little more about that game, how it went from your perspective. Were you surprised that Shaddai played so well? Did you expect it to be harder or easier? Just tell us how you felt about it.
Well, in the last interview, I said that Undead was my favorite matchup, and it was probably 60-40 to me.
Mm-hmm.
And since the score was 3-2, I guess 60-40 was a very good prediction.
Yeah.
The games was really one-sided, I think, besides the last one, which was in his favor for a very long time. But
yeah,
somehow I managed to come back and win the game. But the four games before that, I think it was either one-sided for him or one-sided for me. So pretty strange, because playing the same strategy, it shouldn't be that kind of up and down, but that's how Warcraft is.
Were you happy with your performance, or do you think, I could have actually played that a little bit better here and there?
Definitely the games I lost, I could have done much better, but I know that he feels the same way, so that's the fun part with Warcraft, that there is always like 10 things you can improve each games, even if you win, so.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm never totally satisfied, but if I win, I can't complain.
That's great. A true master always strives for perfection, even when he wins. That's good.
Indeed.
So are you following the WGL Winter Tournament at all at the moment? Do you have time for that?
I have it in the background when I work from home on the iPad. So mm-hmm. time to time, I've been watching some games, but I see that the Night Elves are not doing very well. So
yeah.
It's not been the most fun tournaments to watch from a Night Elf's perspective.
Yeah, it's true. Moon not making it out of the group's phase. Law Lied. A lot of good Night Elves didn't make it, unfortunately. And that is also the transition to my next question. What do you think is Night Elf's state at the moment? Do you think Night Elves are struggling in all matchups? Do you think they still have some hidden strengths? Or what is your take on the Night Elf race at the moment?
I think we struggle a lot against human.
Mm-hmm.
And it's pretty 50-50 against Undead and Orc, I would say. So I don't think we are, how to say, imbalanced or in a big favorite position against any race right now. So yeah, we are struggling a bit. I would say that, definitely.
And toughest matchup, you said it, is against human at the moment, and a lot of people agree on that. It also showed in the very high tier, top tier pro games during several tournaments now. And your next opponent will be a human. Cruncher from NA is going to be your next opponent. And there were some people on Twitter saying that he is one of the top tier humans that are not from China or Korea. Some people would even say on Twitter that he is almost as good as Thorzane, a countryman of yours. So what do you think about that?
I haven't really that much experience of Cruncher. From what I heard, he's a really good and a smart player.
Mm-hmm.
So I've only heard positive things about him. But since I don't have any own experience and I've not been watching his matches that I can remember, of course I downloaded the replays I'm able to, which I found. But so I don't really know that much about him, but I only heard positive things about him. When comparing him to Thorzane, I would say Thorzane is still better. He showed more great results. But yeah, it will be a very, very hard opponent, I would say.
That's for sure. And despite humans currently looking very strong against Night Elves, I think it's still a beautiful matchup from a caster or viewer point of view, because especially Night Elves can play so many styles, you know. So I'm excited to see what you're going to bring against Cruncher. Now, in the grand scheme of things, how comfortable, how well prepared are you for this fight night? You mentioned last time, you know, the late times, it was getting a little late, you were getting a little tired. Do you think you're going to be fighting fatigue and exhaustion a little bit better this time?
Well, we have off to work tomorrow.
Nice.
At work, but I'm on a call this weekend as well, so I won't drink any alcohol. So I will try to get at least 1 or 2 hours of sleep when I come home tomorrow after the work. But this time I would say Cruncher is the favorite. I'm not feeling confident in the matchup against Human. I think it's my worst matchup.
Okay.
I've been trying to practice some with Thorstein this week and just analyze many replays.
How did it go?
The first day went pretty good, and the second day it didn't go good at all. So, and it feels like I'm that kind of player. One day I'm playing really, really good and I can beat the best in the world, and the next day I, for some reason, I can lose to every player and not play good at all. So yeah, I have a high top level and a really low bottom level. So.
Well, then let's hope for the best for tomorrow's fight night, that you're going to show up in a really high tip-top level, little DC. Any final shout-outs, any final words before you send you off?
No, just thank you to Thorstein for the game so far, and hope we can manage to play some more before the fight night. And see you guys on Saturday night.
Exactly. See you guys on Friday/Saturday night, wherever you are in the world. We're starting the action tomorrow on Friday at twitch.tv/heroeshearth. Make sure to follow us there to catch all the action. If you can't make it for whatever reason, we're still going to bring you the VOD, the VOD here on the YouTube. So feel free to subscribe to us here as well. We'll see you there on Friday. Thank you very much for watching, and have a good one.